Today we're going to talk about one of the worst invasive plants in the US, Elaeagnus. The genus Elaeagnus contains several different species, three common ones, silverthorn, Russian olive, autumn olive. What we have here is silverthorn. It has these characteristic silver backing of the leaf with these little spots. There's also lots of thorns on this thing, silverthorn. Here's a big one right here. And if you look carefully, you've got little tiny ones, ouch, underneath each of those leaves. Elaeagnus was brought over to this country about 1880, late 1800s, as a erosion control. So it was planted on places that were like old mines and they needed to put something in there to reclaim that land. They were also promoted heavily in the 50s, 60s, and 70s for wildlife purposes. These produce berries and things love to eat these berries. Birds love to eat them, but then how does it spread? Birds eat the berries, birds poop, boom, you have Elaeagnus growing all over the place. Controlling Elaeagnus is not impossible. It just takes a little bit of effort. My lab has been working with Audubon SC on a large tract to try to figure out how can we control this in big areas. Today, we'll talk about a couple methods. But first, we need protection. Hand protection, head protection, eye protection, long sleeves, long pants, and boots. One option is a foliar herbicide application. This is where we have our sprayer and we are just going to spray and coat the foliage or the leaves of these plants that we want to kill. We've got our chemical inside here. We want to make sure we back up as we spray because you don't want to spray and then walk through all that chemical and get it all over yourself. So as we spray, we back up, coat those leaves so they're wet but not dripping. And boom, there is foliar herbicide application. Now we're gonna take care of this whole plant with the cut stump method. The first part of that method is cutting the stump. You need to get a saw, put your gloves on, your eye protection, and you're simply gonna cut this thing off. Once you have this cut, it's important to treat this really quickly, within 30 seconds to a minute. You're gonna wanna brush off the sawdust, take your herbicide, spray it right on the top of that stump. That plant will suck that herbicide down into the roots. That will kill the roots and prevent resprouts.
Dave is now going to cut an entire silverthorn.
We are going to cut this plant. Hi, Rob. Here's one plant. One plant out of who knows how many. No, it wasn't easy. No, it was not. If you look behind me, this whole area used to be full of Elaeagnus. Through a combination of foliar herbicide application, mechanical removal, we took care of it. It's all gone. There's a few things we need to spot treat. Little ones will come up later. Maybe they were missed the first time. Maybe they came from seed. But a little foliar herbicide will take care of those. By doing this, we've taken this whole area and made it so all the native plants can regrow and reclaim that land. With a little bit of effort, Elaeagnus can be broken, controlled, taken out of here. It takes a little bit of effort, but if you put in the work, you can reclaim all sorts of land for native wildlife and native plants.